I just wonder what Daniel Jacob Radcliffe is going to miss most about Harry James Potter.
I think about the actual experience of filming the movies, I think, you know, I'll miss the crew a huge amount. You know, I'm doing The Woman in Black at the moment, and I'm already working with people who've worked on Potter again in a different context. But, you know, to be together as that unit for so long was very, very special, and I'll miss that. But also, it's very, you know, it's something, I think the one thing I'd say I took for granted over the 10 years was the fact that I was actually playing an action hero as well. And you get to do stuff when you play an action hero that you just don't get to do in any other line of performance or anything. You know, I got to at one point slide down 40-foot free fall down a roof on the fourth film in the dragon sequence. I got to burst out of the water surrounded by a ring of fire on number six. You know, like, I got to do some really cool stuff. And I probably won't get to do stuff like that much anymore.
If we moved to Glasgow, you could probably do that most weekends. So
that would be fun. Right, yes. I would be foolish to agree with you.
that notion too that school's out now forever and you're going to become somewhat a muggle once more. And I don't know whether, like the Beatles, when they wrapped it up with the Abbey Road, they sort of said, boy, you're going to carry that weight a long time, knowing that they'll be a Beatle for the rest of their life. I guess a part of you knows that, you know, you're going to do, you've done other work, you'll do other work, your life will move on. But for some people, there'll be always that sort of, hey, you're the guy who...
I know that. I think I'd be very stupid to think that, you know, I would wake up the day after rap and suddenly everyone would totally forget that I played this character for 10 years. You know, there will be some people who will always see me as this character, and I absolutely know that and understand that, and that's fine. You know, as long as those people are not casting directors and filmmakers, then hopefully that won't hold me back too much. That's kind of my attitude towards it.
I was thinking your growing pains, normally people capture their growing pains on camera phones and home movies, and you've captured it over a multi-billion dollar franchise, a movie that's made 4.7 gazillion, I think, at this point.
Yes.
I don't know whether there's a part of you that sort of mourns not having had an ordinary sort of adolescence, or maybe you and Emma and Rupert are too busy having money fights to worry about such things.
Yeah, I don't wish. I like the idea. I mean, to be honest, I don't think it was a worry that we particularly, you know, lost our adolescence or anything like that. I think, you know, of course, we didn't have what people would consider a normal adolescence in that we were on film set for most of that time. But, you know, in my head, it was a much improved one because there's a lot less bullying and cruelty on a film set than there is at school. So I got to miss out, in my mind, in all the crap parts of being a teenager, which is, generally speaking, hanging around with other teenagers en masse, which is something I didn't particularly enjoy in my brief periods when I did go back to school. And you know, I actually got to hang around with some really kind of cool people, as well as all the other people my age on set. I got to hang around with people who were much older and could just turn around to me and say, yeah, you know what, the problems you're going through in your teenage life that you at this point think are the biggest thing in the world and you will never forget and you will remember forever, you're going to have forgotten about them in 3 weeks' time. They will no longer be a concern of yours. So I think having people around me who've been through puberty and all that rubbish and were sort of quite balanced about the whole thing was actually a real help.
I don't know if I've got time for one more. Was that a one? Yeah, very tiny. George Lucas, he proved very, very painfully that sometimes a franchise is best left alone when he made those horrible prequels to the original Star Wars trilogy. J.K. Rowling has said in Oprah she's tempted to return to Potter in some way. You joke that maybe in 30 years' time there'll be a remake and you play the teachers.
I can say I hope she certainly won't mind me mentioning this. I got a text from J. Rowling yesterday saying... that something along the lines of, you know, I was so pleased with your performance in this film. As a reward, I promised never to write another book about Harry. So, you know, I'm going to leave it to her. I don't think she will. I'm sure she'll write other books and they will be fantastic. I doubt very much she'll be a Harry. I think she feels, as I do, that we have, you know, spent a long enough time with these characters and that, you know, newer pastures are waiting for us all.
Rock and roll. Let me talk to you again.
Thank you very much.